Wouldn't it be great if you could visualize empty space within assemblies? Here's a way to do it. Here is a box with a few simple solids thrown into its cavity. The box and the solids within it have all been created as components. By the end of this video, you would be able to create a solid out of the empty space in the cavity. This can be done by one of two methods, the combine command or the boundary fill command. Let's start with the combine command. We would first need to create a dummy body that fully encompasses all the solids in question, including the box. Let's create this as a separate component. Make sure that the top level is activated. Go to Create, New Component. Rename the new component Dummy. Check that the new component is created in the browser. With the new component active, let's create a sphere that fully encompasses the box. I'm going to choose one of the primary planes and select the origin. Adjust the size of the sphere until it covers the whole box. After confirming the operation, you can switch to a wireframe display. Or adjust the opacity of the sphere to check that the box is fully enclosed. It does not matter what kind of shape the dummy has, as long as it fully encompasses the box. Go to Modify, Combine. The idea here is to use the box and the bodies within it as cutting tools to cut away material from the dummy sphere. For target body, select the sphere. This is the body from which you want to remove material. Before we proceed to select the two bodies, let's change the operation to cut so that we can see our selections better. For two bodies, select the box, the bodies inside. To select the inner bodies, do a long left click until a window pops up showing the list of overlapping bodies. Hover over the bodies until you see the correct body being highlighted and click again to select. Or, if you prefer, you can go to the browser and expand the bodies folder for each component and select the appropriate body. Since we are already in the environment of a new component, we can leave the new component option unchecked. After the operation, we still want the box and the bodies inside it to remain, so check the Keep Tools option. Confirm the operation. Hide all components except the dummy. If we expand the bodies folder, you can see two bodies. A sphere with a cavity in the middle that is in the shape of the box. And the solid created out of the negative space within the cavity of the box. This is the solid that we need. The boundary fill method is actually the faster method as it does not require a dummy model. But I would not recommend this method as it is not user-friendly in its current state. As with the previous method, create a new component. With a new component active, go to Create, Boundary Fill. For tools, select the box and the bodies within it. As with before, you can use the long left click method or select from the browser. Once done, click on Select Cells. The Boundary Fill command is able to detect empty space between the bodies inside the box and fill that in with a solid. The aim here is to select the correct cell. If you hover over the correct cell, you can see the cell turning a slightly paler green. Click on the checkbox. As you can see, the change in color is negligible, and it might take a few guesses to get this right. It is for this reason that I hesitate to recommend this command. For operation, select New Body, and leave the Remove Tools option unchecked. Unhide the box and the rest of the solids.